Hey everyone, I'm going to do my second review today. This review is going to be of Korbanth's Graflex. This is the 2.1. I bought this in, I think, July this past year. This actually was my first build, and I actually completed this probably around August or September, but I've never actually gotten around to actually doing a review, so I figured why not do it today. I have made a lot of modifications to this to try to make it more screen accurate. Thanks to the Graflex Addicts page for all of that. That's a wealth of knowledge. If you're just receiving a Korbanth Graflex now with the recent shipment that he just did, I highly recommend going to that page on Facebook to talk to some of the guys there. Matthew Duley, thank you very much for the Let's Build a Graflex YouTube videos. I followed that step by step to get this done. Without that video, I don't think I could have made not just this saber, but the ones I have made so far after that. So thank you very much. This is a Blue Roy Blue White tri-cree. It's a Spark 2 soundboard. There is a crystal chamber in here. 2-watt premium bass speaker, 3.7 volt battery. And a lot of the modifications that I have in here removed all of the hex screws. So everything is gone. I have in here all the little rivets throughout the entire handle section, rib section. In the pommel also, I have the KR Sabers Graflex cap, as well as riveted in the, this is the Wannawanga Kobold clip. I have the Slothfurnace Empire Strikes Back card. Underneath that is the Shtok's from Shapeways, his clamp card activation switch. The beer tab that I believe Tom Jefferson from the Graflex Addicts page flattened for me. I have Roman's red buttons. These were the last things to finally come in. I think these things finally arrived in late January, so I was actually really happy to get those done. KR Sabers slide screw over in here. What else? ARKM's blade plug. I'll take that out in a second and show everybody that. And then, of course, the Goth night chassis that's inside here. So, yeah, why don't I take that out? Let me get this thing started. I had never thought about doing an actual saber or building my own until I saw this thing come out. I missed out on the first couple of runs at the beginning of the year last year, and I was excited to find out that they were going to be doing another one, and I was able to get in on it. And I mean, how ironic is that? You know, the first saber I build is Graflex. I was not sure how that was going to go, but after spending a good amount of money on all the tools and materials to build it, there was really no turning back, and I was actually really happy that I did it. It gave me a new set of skills, and you know, a new set of confidence actually to doing something like this that I never would have thought a year and a half ago that I would have been able to do. So I'm actually pretty excited that not only has this been my first saber, but it was not my last. I was actually able to do a few more since then, and I'll probably end up doing even a few more from now. So with that, off just to reveal the crystal chamber. That's going off here. Thank you. trying to get all the alignments correct. And throw the cap back on. I have to say, even though that I know there's a lot of gripe with the accuracy of the 2.0, the 2.1, the finish and the shine of the hilt itself compared to a vintage Graflex, as well as the clamp, and all the inaccuracies of the hex screws and everything else that comes through with this. Part of the fun was actually going through and getting all of those things, to be quite honest with you. Talking to so many different people on the Graflex Addicts page on where to get these items, who was selling them, who was making them, and then just to see once I started rolling in how much fun it was to actually start putting them together. I actually forgot the brass tabs here. This also was from someone on the Graflex Addicts page that was putting these together. I'll list the name. It's slipping me right now, but I'll figure out the name and I'll put it in the description below. I did a dual activation with this after watching Shamim's videos a dozen or so times. I did the red button activation as well as clamp card activation. Okay, so let's just get this turned on.
I want to learn the ways of the Force and become a Jedi like my father.
I believe this is Wandsmith's Graflex 4, if I'm not mistaken. This is Bespin, actually. Sorry about that. Because I ended up doing a blue, royal blue, white, I ended up on the Graflex 4 HD, I ended up doing, I mixed in a little bit more of the white to make it a little bit brighter, or a little bit of a lighter blue. But then on Empire Strikes Back, it's full blue, royal blue. I might have mixed just a tiny bit of white in there. And then on the next sound font. This is Shamim's Graflex TFA. A little bit of a long intro for this font. Very bassy with this one, but it just fits really well. I love the differences between 4, 5, and 7 for the Graflex and the changes that it's kind of gone through. Obviously, this is the Empire Strikes Back configuration that I went with.
Back. I want to learn the ways of the Force and become a Jedi like my father.
Alright, so my blade retention is right here. Again, thank you to Daniel George for these slotted screws. I was able to get some of the longer ones through him. That was always a very big help. Again, ARKM's blade plug. I did the black with the aluminum. This is Vader's Volts, 36-inch, 7/8 blade. Okay. Just gonna dim the lights a little bit. This is the episode 4. Graflex 4HD. Let me get the best one going. And this is much more blue. I'm not sure if it shows that up on camera a little bit. Kind of light's probably blinding that out just a little bit, but it's definitely a really nice blue on this. Trying to get a lockup going. There it is. Okay. All right. It was a real challenge at first, getting everything together and figuring out how I was going to do this. But luckily with the videos by Matt Duley, just kind of takes you through step by step, and I'm happy to say that I've used a couple of his videos going forward to help with the recharge ports and some other things, just to make sure I got the wiring correct. That was probably the scariest thing, was finally putting everything together. But I don't think anything's better than pulling the kill key and actually hearing the boot up sound. That's probably one of the best sounds, knowing that you didn't screw up and that it actually is going to work. So if you are just getting a Korbanth 2.1, I would highly recommend using the Let's Build a Graflex videos. They're very simple. He uses a Nano Biscotti, which is a fairly simple board, but I think it works really, really well, and Matt takes you through step by step. It's a great, great video for people that are just starting out trying to build some sabers. I'm just making these for fun, just for me, some family members and stuff. I'm not really going crazy. I've done one other crystal chamber that was on my Soul's Hole Luke V2, which I plan on doing a review on at some point in time soon. It's been a long time since I've had this finished, and I really should have done a review a while ago. But I'm just happy that I'm getting it done now. Any questions or comments, guys, list them below. And thank you guys for watching. All right, have a good night.